efficiency of your brain depends on adaptivity of your neural network. To activate most of the neurons, you need to work on your brain. And reading is the most efficient way to make your brain most active. Because practice of reading books create a cognitive engagement that enrich your vocabulary, invoke creative thinking, boost your concentration, and gives you wisdom. Hello, it's Vikram Singh and you're watching AI Venture. And today I'm going to talk about 4 efficient Python books for beginners that I personally prefer. So let's begin with number 1. Learn Python the hard way, written by Zed Shaw. Before you start doing anything creative in programming, you first need to understand the building block of that language. And that's what this book will take you through. While reading this book, you will always find it will compel you to write down the code. And that's what coding demands. If you make it till the end, trust me, you are the guy who can confidently say, yes, I know the basics. Because you do this while practicing a lot. With the help of this book, you will do incredible simple things that all programmers do to learn a particular programming language. Go through each exercise, type them, just get your hand dirty, and then run the code. That's it. At the beginning, it is pretty typical for you. If you will stick with it, you will have a good foundation. Learn Python the hard way consists of 52 brilliantly crafted exercises, and that's the best thing about this book. Surely enough, this book won't turn you a programmer overnight, but it will get you started on the path to learn how to code. Moving on to number 2, automate the voting stuff with Python, written by Albert Sweigart. If you create a list of 5 all-time best books of Python, you will surely find this book in your list. This means this is among the best. Yes, I don't read this book completely, but yet I'm talking about, I go through few sections of it, like bootstrapping one, working with JSON and CSV file, sending emails and text messages using Python, manipulating the images, and few more. And while reading, I really feel the content of this book is so well structured and all the problems are so efficiently and deeply attached with the core concept of Python. And that's what I like most about it. Because while practicing, this book always lets you think the code, make your brain work. And this way, it enhances the power of your brain and thinking capability regarding the code. Moving on to number 3. Python, a crash course, written by Eric Matthes. Now, this is pretty interesting, guys. I don't even read a single section of this book, but still, I'm talking about it because of its diverse popularity over different platforms. And to check that, recently I raised a question over Quora regarding this book, and I'm so surprised with the result that 9 out of 10 people rated this book more than 4.5. And even it has a good rating over O'Reilly, Amazon, Flipkart, and that's what let me put this book in my list. So it's a people's choice. And that's what inspired me to put this book in my list. So it's a people's choice. And I'm looking forward to read this book. If any one of you read this book, please let me know in the comment section what's your experience with it. Moving on to number 4. Learning Python by Matthes. It's a book that I generally prefer when I want a kind of deeper knowledge regarding a particular topic. All the queries and concepts in this book are practically and theoretically written. But here, 2 things I really want to share with you guys because I read this book. That's why I really want to share my experience with you guys for that particular work. First one, don't prefer this book if you just begin with Python. Because this book has a huge amount of content and if you go through it, it will take a lot much time and that will probably frustrate you. Second one, its size. The size of this book is pretty huge. You can't carry this book with yourself while you're traveling. And I'll show you. Here it is, Learning Python. Look at the size of this book. It consists around 1600 pages. And it's really painful for me to carry this book while I'm traveling because I love to read while I'm traveling. So if you have that kind of tendency, then I must say that please take care about the size of this book. So in the end, if you just begin with Python, I suggest you guys go with the first 3. And if you need more in-depth knowledge, go with the 4th one. And these are my views. You could have a different opinion regarding this book. If you have, please let me in the comment section what you guys think about these books or my list of top 4 programming books for Python. Link of all these 4 books available in the description. Please check that out. And thanks for watching. If you're new over here, consider subscribing. Just hit that subscription button, because here we talk about Python and artificial intelligence. That's what present and future demand. Now I'm going to go to work further on the Python series of basics. Till then, bye bye. See you in the next video.